Hello student, today we will study about the graph of the function. Okay, so in graph of function, firstly we have to study about how many types of graphs and how we'll make the graph of different functions. So let's see what is graph first. Graph. So basically, graph is the a diagram. Okay. Which is representing the two variables, one on x axis and second on y axis. Okay. So, graph basically is a diagram which is representing the two variables on x axis and y axis. So, one terms here, that means after graph many types of functions. So, what is function here? So, start what is function firstly we will discuss, and after that we will study some graph related to the function. Okay. So, function. Okay. Function, that means for function we have to consider two non-empty sets. So, just I am considering here, let A and B two non-empty set. Okay. For function, firstly we have to consider two non-empty set. Now, after that we have to define a function from set A to set B. So, function from set A to set B, we are representing here f such that A to B, that is function from A to B, f is a map on set A to B, mapping corresponds, many terms we are using, but simply function from A to B we can write here f such that A tending to B. Now, function from A to B, that means what is here? Firstly, for function we have to need two non-empty set A and B. So, what condition should be here for function? That is, function should be subset of A cross B. This is very important condition. Function is subset of A cross B. Now, so in A cross B you will get the ordered pairs, because in Cartesian product already we have studied about that. When you multiply two set, we will get the ordered pairs. So, that means in first, that is in ordered pairs, suppose that I have written here AB. So, in this ordered pairs, small a relate with B. Okay. So, function is same here, that means function is basically the case of a specific case of relation. Okay. So, function from set A to set B is a rule which link every element of set A with a set B. Okay. Function is a rule. Okay. Function is a rule from set A to set B, by which every element of set A has a unique image in set B, or we can say that every element of set A by the function rule link with the unique element in set B. Okay. So, for example, just I am considering a function set A and set B. So, set A consisting 1, 2, 3, and now just I am using a rule f of x is equal to 2x. Okay, f of x is equal to 2x. So, I have considered one function or one rule or one formula, we can say that. Now, when we apply this rule on set A, like on a one, we when we apply, then 2 into 1 is equal to 2, 2 into 2 you will get 4, 3 into 2 6. That is, every element of set A has a unique image, that is one link with the 2, that is one. Set A is the known as a domain. Okay, basically is a, this is domain of function and this is codomain. Okay, this is codomain. Now, what is the domain? That is simple. If a function from A to B, so set A is known as a domain and set B is known as a codomain. And collection of image, that means 2, 4, 6 is image here and 1, 2, 3 is pre-image. Now, here 1 is left. Okay, that means if you are defining a function from natural number to natural number, so 1, 2, 3 is left, 4, 5, 5 is left. So, range, what is it? That is only collection of image. So, 2, 4, 6, this is range for this function, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this is codomain. So, basically range is the subset of codomain. Okay. Now, this function, so function basically is a rule from set A to set B, by which every element of set A link with unique element of B. Okay. Now, we will study some graph of different type of function. So, firstly, we have to divide function in two parts, function are basically are two types. One is algebraic function, and second is transcendental function. Okay, so function basically are two types, one is algebraic and transcendental. So transcendental means which is not an algebraic, which is not algebraic. Okay, so in algebraic function, how many types of algebraic function? So let's see, algebraic function are basically polynomial. Okay, in algebraic function, first is polynomial, and after that rational. Okay, third is irrational, and fourth is piecewise function. So in piecewise, that is, this will divide the graph in different portions. So that's why this name is piecewise function. So in piecewise function, how many types are piecewise function? Sinum function. Okay, modulus function. Okay, greatest integer function, smallest integer function, fractional, part of function. So these are piecewise function. Okay, so and transcendental function, that means which is not an algebraic. So these are, that means like trigonometric function. Okay, trigonometric function, inverse trigonometric, inverse trigonometric, and logarithmic function, logarithmic. Okay, and inverse logarithmic, exponential, exponential, geometrical, geometrical curve. Okay, so only these are important, inverse, trigonometric, and logarithmic exponential we will study here. Okay, and geometrical curves and many more curves are there. So basically transcendental function which is not an algebraic. Okay, so function basically are two types, algebraic and transcendental. In algebraic function, polynomial, rational, irrational, piecewise, in piecewise sinum function, modulus function, greatest integer, smallest integer, fractional part of function, and in transcendental, trigonometric, inverse trigonometric, logarithmic, and exponential. Okay, so start with the polynomial function. How to make the graph of polynomial function? So graph of polynomial function. So firstly, we have to define what is polynomial function. Okay, so polynomial function, polynomial function. So polynomial function, if let f of x is equal to a naught plus a 1 x plus a 2 x square plus dot dot a n x power n. Okay, this is standard form of polynomial function, where a naught, a 1, a 2, dot dot a n are real numbers. So real number, again this I am defining real number. That means if you are taking the square of a number and you are getting the positive number, so that number is known as a real number. Okay, like if you are taking the square of minus 1, then you will get the positive, a square of under root 2, you will get the positive. So that's why this is a real number. A simple definition, combination of rational and irrational numbers is known as a real number. And the power of x is not negative integers in polynomial function. So let's see how many types of polynomial function. So first, that means if you are taking f of x is equal to a naught. Okay, f of x is equal to a naught, this is representing the constant function. And if you are taking two terms, like first we can take here f of x is equal to a naught, this is constant function, and second a constant polynomial we can say that, and second is if you are taking two terms a naught plus a 1 here, this is representing linear or identity function, linear or identity function. If you are taking three terms, f of x is equal to a naught plus a 1 x plus a 2 x square. So, this is representing quadratic, quadratic polynomials, and after that cubic and so on, cubic by quadratic and so on. So, start with the constant function, how to make the graph of constant function. So, graph of constant function. So, for constant function, first constant function. Constant function is defined by y is equal to f of x is equal to k, k is any constant. Now, domain of this function, domain that is for all value of real number, this will be defined. So, what is that is why we are using real number, because these are real valued functions. So, what is real valued function? That means, if because in function we have already taken two non-empty set. So, if a and b, that is element of a and b, are subset of real number, then function from a to b is said to be real valued function. That means, real number to real number we are defining here. So, domain of function, what will be here? Real number, because for all real number function will define. For domain and range only we have to check the existence of function, and if function is existing for that value, so it will exist in the domain of the function. And for that point if your function is not existing, so this will not be the part of the domain of the function. Like in case of 1 by x, so 1 by x when will be, it will be exist if x not equal to 0. X not equal to 0, when x equal to 0 then function will not be exist. So, domain of for this function r minus 0. Now, domain of this function is real number, and range of this function is k. Now, just make the general graph of constant function. So, for graph, that means this is a diagram which is representing two variables. So, two variables, what is here? One is x and one is y, that means one on x axis and one on y axis. So, that means y is equal to k, y is equal to k which is parallel to x axis. So, just if I am taking here, this is k point, and now you will get the parallel line to the x axis, this is y is equal to k. So, this is a representation of constant function. So, very easy, that means the domain of function will be real numbers and range of the function will be constant. Like if you have taken y is equal to 2, so y is equal to the f of x is equal to 2. So, x will be real, that is for all real number function will be defined, and range of function will be 2. So, k may be any real value we can take here. Now, second function. Linear function or linear or identity function. So, for linear identity function, firstly it is defined by y is equal to f of x is equal to x, y is equal to f of x equal to x. So, let us see what, and domain and range firstly discuss, what is the domain of this function. Domain of f is, that is for all real x, that is for all real value this function will exist, that is why this is real number, and range of this function is also real number. And y is equal to x, so already we are knowing that y is equal to mx plus c in quadratic geometry, we have studied about y is equal to mx plus c, c is the intercept on y axis. And if y is equal to mx has given, so that type of equation that is always passed from the origin and make 45 degree with positive direction of x axis. So, just only we have to make this diagram, and so for this what will be the identity function by graphically, the x axis, y axis, and this line is making the 45 degree with the positive direction of x axis, this is 45 degree. So, this is identity function or linear function. is power f x, x is there, it is always you will get a straight line and which pass from the origin. Now, second, third function, quadratic. Okay. So, the simplest form we are taking here, third is quadratic. Okay. So, this quadratic function, just I am defining a y is equal to f of x is equal to x square, this is representing the parabola. Okay. So, we have to make the graph for this one. Now, firstly, we will discuss what is the domain and range of this function. So, domain of this function is, that is for all real number this will be defined. So, domain of this function will be real number, and range of the function will be, that means when you put negative numbers then you will get the positive, like minus 1 square positive, okay, minus 2 square positive. So, the range will be here 0 to infinity, negative numbers will be disappear because here is square term is there. Now, just how to make the graph of this function. So, this is parabola, upward parabola, and if you are taking the right hand parabola, so this is not a function, okay, because this is by vertical test, if you are taking a vertical lines then it will intersect at two points. Okay. So, that is why it is not function. So, only parabola this I am considering here, upward parabola. So, for this, this is y is equal to x square. Okay. Y is equal to x square, this is representation of upward parabola, that is upward parabola, downward parabola, and right hand parabola, left hand parabola, but here we have to use here upward parabola. Okay. So, this is representation of y is equal to x square, and domain of function is real number and range of the function is 0 to infinity. Now, next one, if you are taking cubic, okay, cubic polynomial, fourth is cubic polynomial. So, cubic polynomial is defined by y is equal to f of x is equal to x cube. Okay. So, y is equal to f of x is equal to x cube. So, domain of this function is equal to real number and range of this function is real number. Now, how to make the graph of y is equal to x cube? So, just make it the graph of y is equal to x cube. So, just this y axis and this is z axis. Okay. Now, for graph of y is equal to x cube, like that you will get the graph. Okay. That is, this is upward increasing and this is downward increasing, minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay. And this is symmetrical about the origin. In case of quadratic, this is symmetrical about the y axis. That means, the power is, if x power 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on is there, that means it is symmetrical about the y axis. In case of if power is odd, like 1, 3, 5 and so on, then it is symmetrical about the origin. Okay. That part is similar to that part, that like when you place your mirror, then this is the equivalent, that means this is the image of that portion, or this is the image of that portion is this. Okay. Now, this is a graph of y is equal to x cube. Now, we have to consider a general form for y is equal to like x square x power 4, how to make the graph of this one. So, let us see next one. Okay. So, I am considering a general form function y is equal to f of x is equal to x power 2 n, where small n belong to natural number. Now, we have to make the graph of for this function, like x power 2, x power 4, x power 6, and now just discuss some comparison value of x power. So, if you are taking here comparison value of x, like x that is x square, x power 4, x power 6 is there, and we are taking the value here x from minus infinity to plus infinity. So, what is the comparison value of between x square, x power 4? So, if you are taking here minus 1 to plus 1. Okay. That means, if x belong to, minus 1 to plus 1, then x square is greater than x power 4, is greater than x power 6, is greater than and so on. Okay. Let us see here, minus 1 to plus 1. Okay. Like if you are taking here 0.5, So 0.5 square, that is 0.5 means 1 by 2, 1 by 2 square, that means 1 by 4. Now if you are taking 1 by 2 power 4, so 1 by 2 power 4, that means main, that's if denominator is increasing, so the value of fraction will be less, like 1 by 2, 1 by something like that you will get. So in higher power, the denominator will be high, that's why the value will be less. So that's why x square here is greater than. And second interval, x belong to minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. In that case, this reverse order will get. Okay. Like x square is less than x power 4, is less than x power 6, and less than, and so on. Now, how to make the graph of x square, x power 4, and x power 6? So, let us see graph of x power 2n. Yes, only we have to make here x square and x power 4. So, for this, we have to make here 2 axis, x axis, and y axis. Okay. Now, let's make one line y is equal to x, and this is y is equal to minus x. Y is equal to minus x, and this is y is equal to x. Okay. Now, we have to make the graph of x square and x power 4. So, x square, like that we will make the graph of x square. This is y is equal to x square. Now, for second, that this is a point here minus 1, and this is point here plus 1. Now, again just we have, if you are making the graph, so this is the intersecting point. Like that we will get the graph. This is y is equal to x power 4. Okay. That is, this is a line y is equal to x square and y is equal to x power 4. So, y is equal to x square, it is close to y equal to minus 6, and after that y x power 4, x power 6, like that you will get. And here also x square close to y equal to x, and x power 4, x power 6, and x power 8, like that you will get. Okay. So, this is the even function, and for even function always it is symmetrical about y axis. Next one is odd function we have to discuss. So, for odd function y is equal to, next one, y is equal to f of x is equal to x power 2n minus 1, where small n belong to natural number. That means, like form x cube, x power 5, and so on. Okay. This is odd function. In odd function always it is symmetrical about the origin. Now, we have to make the graph for x power 3, x power 5. So, let us see how to make the graph. Let us make the x axis and y axis. Okay. And just make one line y is equal to x. Okay, is y is equal to x. Now, we have to represent here, this y is equal to x. Now, we have to represent here y is equal to x cube. So, x cube already we have made here. So, this is yes, and this is minus 1, and this is plus 1. This is intersecting point. That is when we will make the y x power 5. So, always it will pass from that point. Next one. Okay, this is y is equal to x power 5, this is y is equal to x cube, and like that you will get the graph. Now, if you will study the comparison value, so in comparison value, that means if you are comparing the value of comparison value of x cube, x power 5, and so on. For this, we have to make the interval. In different intervals, we will discuss about the value of different, what is the value of x and x cube and x power 5. So, if you are taking the interval, if x belong to 1 to infinity, so in that interval, x is less than x cube, less than x power 5, and less than, and so on. Okay. Second interval, if you are taking, if x belong to 1 to 0, then just reverse order you get, x is greater than x power 3, greater than x power 5. you can consider one example also, like if you are taking a 2, because 2 is belonging to 1 to infinity. Now 2, okay, and 2 cube, 2 power 3, like that, 2 power 5, like that, that is 2 is will be less than. Now between 1 0 if you are taking, like 0.5 if you are taking, 0.5 means 1 by 2. So in 1 by 2, so 1 by 2, 1 by 2 cube, that is 1 by 8 will be, okay. So 1 by 8 is less than 1 by 2, so that is why 1 by 2 will be greater. Now next interval, if x belong to minus 1 to 0, just reverse order, x is less than x cube, is less than x power 5, is less than, and so on. And third interval, if x belong to minus infinity to minus 1, in that case this again you will get the reverse order, x is greater than x cube and greater than x power 5, and so on. Okay, this is a comparison value of odd function x, x cube and x power 5. Okay, so this is a different type of polynomial function and their graph, and already we have discussed about their domain and range. Okay, so in next video we will discuss about the graph of the rational function, irrational function and piecewise function, and after that transcendental function we will study the graph of, and this graph is very important for studying, for just checking how to this function is varying, how it is increasing, how decreasing. Okay, so we have to concentrate on graph, and by using the graph we can define which type of function, like one-one function, on-two function we can define. Okay, we can study the nature of curvature, what is the what is the nature of curves. Okay, so in next video we will discuss about the different type of graph, like relational, irrational and so on. Okay, thank you class.